Hello, I'm Olga from RubyMine, and in this video we'll talk about authentication in Rails and how you can implement it using the Rails 8 generator. Authentication is the process of verifying a user's identity to give them access to specific parts of the app, such as their profile or dashboard. Historically, in Rails, you've had two main options for implementing it: manually, which could be tedious, or use an external gem-like device, which can also have downsides. For example, some developers find device configuration challenging. Additionally, relying on an external gem introduces dependency management, which might make maintenance more difficult over time. But now, the process is much easier, as Rails 8 has introduced a built-in authentication generator that creates essential components for managing authentication. As you can see, at the moment, our application has neither a sign-up button nor a login button. Let's implement them. We'll be using RubyMine, and we can run the generator from the IDE via the Run Anything action. As you can see, this creates user, session, and current models with the corresponding migrations, as well as the sessions controller, the authentication concern that is included in all controllers, and password reset logic. Here we're trying to load the main page of the app, but we are redirected to the login page, which we don't want. So to avoid it, we'll add this line to static pages controller. That will allow us to load the homepage without having to log in. Now, we might want to add a user. However, the authentication generator doesn't actually create a sign-up flow, leaving the implementation to us. So let's see how to set that up. We'll need to generate a controller for the user model. And next, we'll add the sign-up button to our home HTML ERB. Then, we'll add the following line to user's controller. This will allow us to load the sign-up page without being redirected to the login page. It has a similar effect to the allow unauthenticated access line we added before, except here we're only allowing specific roads. So now, the sign-up button leads to a sign-up page, and we can create a new user. Now, let's add the login button to the header. Here, we're making a request to the sessions controller and rendering a page that will allow us to input the username and password. Now, we can click on the button and be redirected to the login page. The generator provides a basic one by default, but you can always customize it like we did here. We can use a Rails session to store the ID of a user who has just logged in. This ID helps us distinguish between users. Let's see how that works. This is the authentication concern, which encapsulates the core authentication logic and session management. We'll add the following line to the start new session for method. It stores the user's ID in the session. Throughout the app, we'll need to know the identity of the current user, so let's write a helper method for that. We'll use the session storage to retrieve the user ID. Now we can distinguish between visitors who are logged in and those who are not, as well as between different users. Here's what the homepage looks like when I'm not logged in. So let's change it. And now, as you can see, it shows the food. You might have noticed that we still have the login button here. Let's replace it with logout for authenticated users. Now we've added logic to toggle between the buttons depending on the user's authentication state. In order to actually log out, we'll need to forget who the current user is, which we'll do by deleting the user ID from the session storage in the terminate session method here in the authentication model. Now we should be able to log out. As I mentioned earlier, the authentication generator also provides password reset logic. Let's open the login page and click on the forgot password link. When we click on email reset instructions, we should get an email in our inbox. And now we can change the password. We hope you found this video useful. Please share your experience of working with Rails 8 authentication in the comments. Thanks for watching.